Baptist church, it's a little church on the side of the road. How many know God is not so much into the size of churches, but he's looking at the condition of the heart. Amen. Amen. And so it's just a blessing to be here. I want you to know that. I want to give honor to my wife. Hallelujah. We've been married 11 years. Hallelujah. I want y'all to know we had an old fashioned honeymoon. Y'all weren't ready for that. I know y'all weren't ready for that. I mean, if you do things God's way, do it his way, you'll be surprised. He'll bless you. The devil's lying every day. Some of y'all in the cookie jar and the candy jar thinking, you know, it's all good, but you missing a blessing. Right. Hallelujah. He taught me, gave me this word today. Is there a doctor in the house?
Right.
Here's the thing for today. And as I said, if you go to my house now, talk about health and wellness, you're not going to find soda in there. You're not going to find cake and donuts. My wife is very, very health conscious. A lot of organic stuff in there. You know, the man of God apologized to me because there were so many presentations. And I'm telling you, don't apologize because this is vision. We need to be doing something. That, listen, protocol is a good thing, but we need to be assessing protocol because a lot of that ain't God. Amen. We need the power of God today, y'all. The devil is busy right now. Our young people now, if you trace our young people, over each decade, over the last three or four decades, the psychology now is changing. Our young people, they don't understand socialization anymore. And everything is this. Amen. They're playing games all day. They're just doing them for killing folks. Uh-huh. Not to mention now, they got games where you're killing innocent people. I don't know about that. I grew up with the notion that the bad guy always lost. You're playing games, you're killing innocent people.
Yeah.
Right. The devil is working the minds.
Yeah.
What you're going to see today is we're not talking about the sickness that affects the body. We're talking about sin sickness.
Sin.
All right? Hallelujah. Can you turn your Bibles to Luke chapter 5? And listen, I'm conscious of the time. I do my job and I sit down.
Right.
Please, pay attention to this role. They gave it to me at the ordination. But behind this robe, I'm a man of integrity. I work hard to represent God. I work hard to govern my thoughts. How many of you know, y'all need to start taking some of the thoughts captive. Amen. Amen. We need to be fine-tuned, church. Hallelujah. Amen. This world, how many of y'all believe? Now, I don't want you to raise your hands unless you really believe it, that Jesus is coming back soon. I mean, don't raise it if you don't believe it. When you look at the condition of the church, you would never think that that's happening. We don't have urgency in the church to represent God in our jobs, in our families. We don't take the time to seek God, pray, ask him for wisdom in all things that we're doing, that somebody might come out of their sickness and get well with Dr. Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. I'm real, y'all. Behind this thing here, God is doing a work. Young people, I was not always sane. I was into a whole lot of nonsense. That's why I bless his name. I could be in hell right now.
My boy.
Oh, hallelujah. Are you there in Luke chapter 5? How are we going to do this? We're going to look at the highlighted scripture. We're going to go back to verse 1. We're going to kind of move along. But we're going to deal with this issue. Amen. Y'all with me this morning? victory in Jesus. Read the end of the book, we win. Oh, hallelujah. I don't know if y'all forgot that, but we win. But we need to act like we're winners. Amen. Holy Ghost, you're moving here now. I know we got to be out of here in a little bit now. Hallelujah. I just want to get acquainted with y'all. I want y'all to know me because, you know, I'm here on business. I work for heaven, not man. Let me read the scripture, y'all. Y'all, in verse 29, are you there?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Then Levi gave him a great feast. I'm reading from the New King James. In his own house, there were a great multitude, a great number of tax collectors and others who sat down with them. And the scribes and Pharisees complained against his disciples, saying, "Why do you eat and drink with the tax collectors and sinners?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are what?" Say that one more time. Those who are what?
Sick.
"I have not come to call the righteous, but the sinners to repentance." Now, if you look at this word sick in the New Testament, there are actually three different Greek definitions that I want to give those to. The first one is asthenia. It is to be feeble and to be diseased. Okay? The second one is arhostos. Those affected by poison. Hallelujah. In other words, we take something in that causes the sickness. This is beyond disease. But the one Jesus is referring to right here is the word there is kakos. It means to be badly, physically, or morally sick. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Here's some other definition: being wrong, being mistaken, inappropriate, disease, evil, miserably sick. So when we talk about sickness, the ultimate sickness is sin.
Yeah.
When you look at the conditions of our world, the issue is sin. Y'all with me now?
Yeah.
All right, now, go back to verse 1 of chapter 5. Yes, amen.
Amen.
Now we're going to drift a little bit, but it's going to come together, all right? So was, as the multitude pressed about to hear him, the word of God, as he stood by the lake Genesaret, he saw two boats standing by the lake, but the fishermen had gone from them and were washing their nets. Y'all know what I'm talking about right there, right? In other words, we done for today. Anybody fish or crab in the house? You know how it is. I love to go crabbing, and you know, at the end of the day, when I'm cleaning up, I'm done. I'm ready to go. But the Spirit is telling me to tell you there are some of us who are dealing with sick family members, and we are basically washing our hands. God is saying, don't give up yet on those that are sick around. Hallelujah. I want to encourage you there. They were washing their nets. They were done for the day. And in this situation, it's a lot worse because, see, if I had a bad day crabbing, it's still a better day than that being at work. Amen. What I'm saying? But when it's your livelihood and you're making money and all of a sudden you've been toiling all night, there's a different feeling there when you're washing the nets. I'm done, man. We didn't catch anything. Finances and all that. But since we're talking about sickness, I want to encourage somebody today. I'm praying for children of mine myself. How many of you praying for children out there? And it looks impossible right now. I got friends of mine, their son is gay. And I'm in agreement with them. Because I'm here to tell you, God will honor your prayer for your seed. So don't lose hope. Don't wash your nets yet. Amen.
Amen.
There's some sick folk all around us.
Yeah.
All around us. And God, the Spirit of God is saying, yeah, wait a minute now. Don't wash them yet. Not yet. Now watch verse 3. Then he got into one of the boats, which was Simon's, and asked him to put out a little from the land. And he sat down and told escort the multitude from the boat. Now, we miss this right here because we see a word before the miracle. Hallelujah. See, most of us associate this story to the fact that just cast your net one more time. No, Jesus said, look, just pull out a little bit. Let me talk to y'all. See, Jesus wasn't a fisherman. He was a carpenter.
Right.
Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But see, because he has all power in his hand. He can operate any atmosphere. See, I'm blessed because I can cancel a doctor, but I can cancel a heroin addict. Because God has worked with me over years and given me wisdom. See, we need wisdom in how to go in certain areas. Y'all not hear me in the house. And I thank God because this example here is teaching us two things. Number one, church, we need the power of God. See, Jesus was packed with power. He wasn't worried about the fact that they didn't catch nothing. He had everything in his hand.
Yeah.
And see, we the church, we lack it in two areas. We lack the wisdom, and we lack in power. Oh, y'all not hearing? See, I'm looking for the power of God. We need him to move. Hallelujah. In order for him to move, the Holy Spirit, now he's not going to make his abode on 6th of. That's why we need a doctor in the house. Some of us, we doing things and you know God has been telling you to stop. You know he's been telling you you're not supposed to be in that area.
Yeah.
Don't be like me now and have him have to knock you down to get your attention. I'm still asking, is there a doctor in the house? And here we have Jesus now. He knows. Jesus, now this is a crucial time for our Lord. He's recruiting. This is a crucial time for the church because we're closing the door right now. And I applaud these young people for being in the house.
Yeah.
You ought to give these young people a hand for being in the church. That's a blessing. And I'm here to tell you, if I had to deal with what they're dealing with,
hey,
I had never made it.
Yeah.
Y'all know what I'm talking about. They're battling some stuff, y'all.
Yeah.
Y'all thought we had some stuff? They battling with some real sickness. Do I have a witness in the house? Look at verse 4. He says, when he had stopped speaking, he said to Simon, launch out into the deep and let your nets for a catch. But Simon answered and said, Master, we have toiled all night and caught nothing. Nevertheless, say that word, nevertheless. One more time, nevertheless. At your word, I will let down the nets. Done this, they caught a great number of fish.
Yeah.
And the net was breaking. So they signaled to the partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled what? Both boats. So that they began to sink. And when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, depart from me. What does he say next? For I am a sinful man. In other words, I'm a sick man. Y'all see what I'm talking about right here? All right, now we're going to close this thing up, go down to verse 15. We're going to look at another story. Notice now, the miracle caused Peter to examine himself even more. When God does miracles in our lives, you know what happens? We lose that drive. Some of us, you know, finally get the man that you've been praying for, and we don't see you at prayer service anymore. Finally got your wife, got your house, got the car, and all of a sudden, now you good now. The miracle ought to cause us to get on our knees even more. Y'all hear the Spirit this morning? Peter saw a miraculous thing happen, but then recognized he's sick. He's a sinner. Miracles have messed me up, y'all. You know how I got where I am? From being in the wilderness, being in them trenches, being in them places where I don't know where you are, God. says doctors, doesn't it? Doctors of the law sitting by would come out from every town in Galilee, Judea, Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was present to heal them. Y'all see that word doctor, right? I was so blessed that the man of God did not read my Bible. Coming into this the Baptist community, I struggled with that because it ain't about me. Don't get me wrong, we need to show ourselves approved. You need to understand this word. You need to have some credentials. But I do believe that there's character. That's a possibility also. Amen. We need to also be. I'm a man of one wife. I love one woman. My eyes are for her alone. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? Everything I have and feel for a woman is for her.
Amen.
And see, my credentials are what? mention the ministry.